In this video, I will explain you about factorization theorem, which is given by Neuman, and it is very important to know this theorem. Only then you can find out whether we are having a sufficient estimator or not. So statement that is given to us is like this: if t is equal to t of x, which is a sufficient estimator for theta, if and only if joint density function, let's say L, of sample values can be expressed in the form L is equal to g theta inside the bracket t of x multiplied by h of x, where g theta t of x depends on theta and x only throw theta and x only throw the value of t of x, and hx is independent of theta. So this value can be dependent on theta and x, and this value must have to be independent of theta. Now Fisher Neuman criteria is like this: a state test is a statistics T1, which is equal to T x1 to xn, is a sufficient estimator of parameter theta if and only if the likelihood function can be expressed as this value. You must have to remember, only then you will be able to solve the numerical question. Likelihood function L is equal to I is equal to 1 to n pi, here you have to take pi, I is equal to 1 to n pi f of xi comma theta, and it can be further written as g1 t1 comma theta multiplied by k up to x1 up to xn, where g1 t1 comma theta is a probability density function of statistics t1, and k1 up to x1 to xn is a function of sample observation only independent of theta. So see this value must have to be independent of theta. It should not contain theta, and this value can contain theta, t1 as well as other things, but this value must have to be independent of theta. Now if it is not clear to you in here, everything will become clear to you while solving the numerical. Just remember that one value is dependent on theta and another value is independent on theta, and it must contain a statistics t. Okay.